Hey MechWarriors, welcome back to Uncle Plays MechWarrior 5, career mode, or I'm sorry, campaign mode, modded. We're here in the Stanzac system, where we left you last time. Been trying to make a real decision on this stalker misery, and I'm still inclined right where I was last time. Gonna have to let it go. It's got decent hard points. The problem is, it's an 85 ton that I really don't have room for. I already got plenty, including another stalker. Although it's not a hero mech, it's a pretty good one as configured for what I want it to be able to do, which is long range missiles, a pair of large lasers, and up close and personal medium lasers. Right now, you can do the math on this if you want. I'm down 5, down 15, down 35, down 50 tons. So I got a 350 ton lance that I can put forward, and that's it. And that's okay for a fast moving lance, which this is, because they're all right there at about 64. Okay, the PB is a little bit faster, but. I do have the King Crab, and I have not yet shoved a XL engine into that. I'm going to go ahead and do that right now, because all my other guys that were using these XL engines have been salvaged, so I might as well do that. We can turn him into a faster mech with the inclusion of 10 more tons of engine. I don't think I got one that'll do that. Not quite enough. It's going to take a 400 or so, huh? Yeah, I don't have it. I'm going to have to start selling them. Put some money in my pocket. Oh, and the market's only got a primitive. Okay, not going to be doing that right now. We'll have to do that some other time. Unfortunately, do believe I'm gonna need that King Crab one to be properly painted. And two to get up to speed, because I just prefer my my mechs to have enough speed to get out of the way of themselves, at least. Some of the end missions are rather long. Having to trundle along at 48.6 is kind of a pain in the butt for both me as a player and probably you as a watcher. Anyway, we are here to go finish up Lifeline, which is right here. Not finish it, start it even, in the Candace system. Mouse over's not going to show me nothing, huh? Okay. This says campaign mission, which in this case means a defense mission. And a rather drawn out and lengthy one. I don't completely recall, but it's close to somewhere along the lines of about 40 targets you have to kill. And that's VTOLs, tanks, etc. 85 campaign at 380 tons. Now that means we know we're going to go into that light, because I am going to be taking faster mechs. That's all there is to it. And the only real decision here is, do I take these guys, or do I in fact make the fateful decision to drop my awesome and put her in the stalker. Where are we at? There we are. Because the stalker at least does in fact have long range missiles that I can use to get far away targets to cease and desist on taking out buildings. It's also 5 tons heavier. I think this is going to have to be it. Okay, zero. That's not so bad. Zero. He's good, and I'm gonna need him up close and personal on things. And I'm at zero. Got a whole bunch of zeros. Let's go do some stuff. See what happens. I promise that was not a fart, that was my keyboard chattering. What a rubber feet. At least it's a cold planet. Don't have to worry about too much about heat. Kind of wishing this guy could have 4 more tons of free space so I could slap a third large laser on it. Quite have enough reach out and touch somebody appeal. Put enough close in your face. With the SRM6s. That's a different story. You know what? I can free up that. I'm gonna have to try that. All of these are Artemis, so that each one of those 4 you have an extra ton for the Artemis control. Wish I'd thought of that about, I don't know, 2 minutes ago.
And not a moment too soon. Now fan out and take defensive positions. Prepare for incoming hostiles.
Greetings, Mercenary. Welcome to our war. We get bombardment on the regular around here, so you won't have to wait too long for something to shoot at.
That VTOL is on our list of targets. Let's make our quarter. Combat vehicle rolling in. Be sure to take it apart.
Let every one of those go through. Oh, I'm so tired of these people not being under control. City to get in range for her long-range missiles. They are the number one weapon. Just not using them.
Hostiles inbound. Brace for contact, Commander.
I would hate to be a VTOL pilot. Know that I'm down here defending.
Target acquired.
Target down.
Target
Yeah, 47 total. That's 13 of them.
Copy, Commander. Lance target confirmed.
Target acquired.
Sorry, can't attack that. Target info received. Engaging.
You got it.
Acquired. More enemies inbound. They really are gunning for you, Commander. Watch out.
There we go.
This should be good.
That matches the class of VTOL we're after. Take it out.
Ma'am, take this one now.
Targeting updated.
Nope, too far away. Pesky SRM missiles just stop. That doesn't make any sense.
Baron here. It's out of here.
Let's go 26.
Target acquired.
Count on it.
I am, Baron. I am. I know what you guys are thinking. He's going to make it to 80%. No, he's not. Here comes the crap. Literally, feces hit the vertical air impeller.
They're heading your way.
Here we come.
We'll be rerouting now, Commander.
Yeah, y'all start crawling this way. Fell down the hill.
Awaiting orders.
Attacking from here.
Fuel reserves just went up in flames, Commander.
Roger. Prioritizing target. Copy that, Commander. Firing.
New target. Awesome.
As ordered.
I'm not seeing the VTOL. Maybe somebody else got it. Please do.
This should be good.
Target acquired.
Engaging designated target.
Nice to stop from not shooting it like I told it to. Now it shoots it. lost behind the mountain ridge here.
Target acquired.
Shoot the spider, shoot the spider.
That took care of him.
13. I have done 88% of this. The spider gets loose, it's all over. And it just got loose.
New target, spider.
Firing on requested target.
No, you're not. Went to the missiles. Somebody shot
Baron.
It.
Enemy mech destroyed.
Good job, Baron. I don't think so. It's all good till the end when they land a dropship right in here. No, I don't have it all memorized. I wish I did. So they get you running across the back of the field. I just told everybody to go for that one so that they all at least start coming this way. Not like me. I don't have an AMS on this map. I'm gonna have to change that.
Looks like you got their attention. I'm showing multiple hostiles incoming on your position.
Yes, six left. Scatter fire getting their attention. All of them.
Hostiles are focusing on the facilities. Engage the hostiles to draw them off the buildings.
That's a wonderful idea. Quickly, it went down to 70. Not for lack of trying. She was supposed to know that the entire time. It never was. Yeah, I lost 20% in the last minute of combat. Still, overall, with the right mechs, that's not a hard mission, even at 47. And I'm here to tell you, if you actually monitor and keep track, you're going to see that some of the end-game missions have up to 90. I think the top I ever did was 96 kills. And that's mechs targets, turrets, tanks, everything all combined. Cyclops parts, I have none. So that's kind of pointless. I can't get one anyway. Nope, can't get that. Don't need those. I'll take a large laser. I'm actually running low on medium lasers, what do you know? Good ones, anyway. I'll take this guy. It's okay, because I'm just about done making mechs, too. Everybody did pretty good, except for these two. But that's not bad, considering, I mean, these two didn't have any affinity in the mechs they were in whatsoever. Major M got a lot of hits, and that's because she got directed to, I assume. Anyway, we'll move along. 3,250 and an extra 4 million. Not shabby. At this point, making reputation level 14 is another still 10,000 points away. And while I do run company rep, and that lets me go all the way up to, I guess, 100 levels, I don't know, never gone beyond 20, they do get further and further apart each and every single time, so. I've never actually looked at this before. This is the cost to keep these mechs open and running per quarter. So when you look at the Hellslinger and it says easy to maintain, this is what it means. And cheap too. Why is the Zeus storage still costing me 14? I guess if they still have equipment on them, they cost money. To some degree at least. But the Kobold's fully, I thought. Gonna have to speak to Rihanna. They won't let you do anything until that's taken care of. She has a very, very full calendar and schedule, and you don't want to mess it up. After all, she's running the ship
Commander,
and the company for you.
I've done it. I've broken the encryption on the first set of coordinates.
About time.
Hey, don't start. I wondered myself if I'd ever crack the encryption. But here we are.
Never doubted you for a minute, Rihanna. What did you find?
Well, not as much as I'd hoped, to be perfectly honest. Take a look. This is the ancient star map we discovered inside the fortress on Xinyang. You can see where the missing section of the map is supposed to be, right here. The coordinates I unlocked point to this location, a system on the innermost edge of the periphery. I researched it as best I could. All I found was its designation, HD276914. From everything we know, it's uninhabited. There's nothing out there, Commander. No colonists, no miners, no reason that anyone's ever even been there.
Why would my father have gone to so much trouble to protect these coordinates? There has to be something out there.
I agree. The question is, what?
There's only one way to find out. I'll get us to those coordinates ASAP.
All right. Once we're there, we'll have a much better idea of exactly what we've unlocked.
Roger that.
Well, I gotta admit, I'm going into this the lowest tonnage I've ever gone in. These are the five remaining missions in the campaign, what I can group together and call the HD missions. They are way over here, all the way across the entire Krita space. Now, I've got to choose. I'm there. stomp the launch, or X marks the spot, is up in here. It gives me a 95-ton Corsair. Which is an okay hero mech. It's not one of my favorites at all. At this point, I'm going to run in the Nightstar. And this is not a bad setup. I just want to say that. This is not a bad setup once I get somewhere where I can buy an engine core. And that's going to have to be my first thing. Is get the King Crab up and ready for full service. But while I'm here still, because it gives me a longer run of time, I'm going to work these guys through training if I can. I cannot hear, so might as well jump back to Stanzac and, I'm going to go to Gunsberg. I don't think it's going to be any better, but I haven't been there, and let's see what they got for a rare mech. I haven't been there recently. Haven't been there in this campaign. Now there are a couple other missions I could run that that have good stuff I can pick up that I know, for hero mechs, etc., that are there. But they're way down in the middle of the map, and that would be a big V I'd have to make. And time-wise, I got a feeling I'd lose your patience. I already know that is the Stalker Misery. I think if I was in the market for running on an 85 tonner, that would be a good one. I'd pick it. Oh, and I gotta remember to look for engine cores. Stop me from having to make yet another stop. Good news is I won't be needing the Stalker on the first mission. Nothing. Isn't that a bummer? Let's get ahead of the curve and see what we have for engines on the market. 365 is it. Let's see what that'll get us on the King Crab. Come on, there you go. You can do it. I should have went ahead and put that XL engine in and just left it under tonnage, shouldn't I? Okay. 59.13. I will do that. Mainly because I'm going to do it anyway. With the XL engine, just to get me the weight savings. Three extra tons. What would you do with three extra tons if you had it? Well, my heat went down. I'm at two now, so that's a partial answer, isn't it? It's like all I'm going to get out of this is speed. That's because the King Crab's a heavy mech. Sorry, it's an assault mech. You know what I mean. 99.5. A couple points of armor on the legs is about all I can do at this point. Got an AMS? No. Max armor it is. 9 days. 4 million C-bills. And that's just to do the add-ons I just did. Gotta do it. Kinda need it. Back down to 24. Yep. Okie dokie. What's in this puppy? I did take the XL out of this. And that's a stripped mech. We'll do a repair all. I'm gonna look at equipment and see what we got. Hello. It's so much, it takes so long. There we go. Nothing. Nothing. And not to be repetitive, but do nada. Okay. Here's what I'm going to do. We'll stop the repairs on this. Since I cannot be sure I'm going to be getting an Atlas anytime soon, and this is going to have to be my do-all be-all. You can do it. Give me the loadout. Why is my computer so slow all of a sudden? The question really is, which arm? Do I have good enough SRMs to do this? Or would I be losing too much? Because the difference really is 5 points of damage in addition to the range. That's the only real difference. If I drop this down to, or these two down, and instead put in that one and this one, it'll be unbalanced, but I'm already down 4 points. Take those two off, put those two in, I'm down 5 points. That gives me 4 tons to play with. And this is a relatively cool mech. Of course, now I've also got to switch out my SRM ammo. And the whole point behind that was to get one more large laser in. And now suddenly I'm up 9 points of damage. Isn't that a wonderful thing? And I've still got 6 tons and don't need that much SRM ammo. I really don't think so. Now the bad news is I still don't have an AMS. Still, I think, within the range for heat, a little marginal, so I'll do a repair all, and I got a ton and a half. I got a couple minor points I can pick up on armor, but not enough for a ton and a half. It's the half ton that's killing me, so I'm going to do that as a SRM, I think, and until that, other than that, I'm going to go ahead and drop the... You guessed it. Double heat sink. I don't want to shave off an extra ton. Or half ton. I would rather... have extra ammo. Some of these missions on the end get long. And extra ammo is always nice. That's one of the reasons I'm looking at this mech as a viable alternative for an Atlas or anything else bigger, is the stone cold fact that it only needs SRM ammo. I can keep shooting for a long time afterwards. And that single medium becomes a good turret picker offer. Especially if I put an SRM-4 chained into it, that might be a good thing to do. 44 days, 100K, cheap at half the cost, or cheap at twice the cost. I'm gonna leave that there. Protects my long lasers, and we'll start. And after all the gets shot off, I got more. The shame is I don't have the War Dog upgrade, so I can't just slap a 15% upgrade on all of these guys. But I can go ahead and slap upgrades on. So this is going to get boring, folks, but I need to do it. I don't want to come back in another episode and suddenly I have all these upgrades in. Well, you see them going in and seeing what differences that they do, in fact, make or don't make. I don't have a lot of upgrades. You know what? Had not been shooting to complete the missions, have I? Back to bite me in the butt. Potent warheads, and I'm not shooting warheads. Not a single missile one. Already got an agility. I'll do that one because, after all, it's all about missiles on this map. And I'm really not sure if it makes much sense to do upgrades when you don't have a lot to do. Now he's got a gun. Oop, that was missiles. Okay. Should go back and put that in if I get an opportunity. Not going to be a lot here. This one has missiles at least. Longer range on everything. It matters. And this guy can always use. Those. Two LBXs, that'll come in handy. Faster missile reload. King Crab always needs torso twist speed. And you can take naps while you're waiting for it to turn from side to side. That's about all we can do. Okay. I'm going to make an executive decision and decide that we are, in fact, going to take a mission somewhere along the line here. But for now, I'm going to pop down to here and see what's available. Or do I go back to my favorite spot? This has been a drought right in here for me. This entire game, I've not picked up anything, anything I've wanted, which would be an assault mech. It's usually heavy for it. For just a random landing. I have 17. It costs 16. Yeah, I'm going to go dragging and screaming my way into the final missions, aren't I? Wouldn't that be the stuff if I just left it sit there? Fortunately, I have stuff to sell. Only got to make it there. Once I make it there, I'm generally speaking good to go. just don't need level 1s. I don't need level 4s, it's end of campaign coming. They're not already installed and shooting. You have to ask yourself, do you really need them? Some of it, the answer is no, but you get so little money, it's just not worth selling it. Never did get that installed. Never run those anyway. I really don't think they're worth the extra heat. Oh, didn't realize I had that. I gotta go back to the, no, I gotta save that, because I might need it for the, I will in fact need that for the Atlas. All three of them. Two of them. Okay, I'm going to be in good shape for the Atlas. I'm back up to 26 million already, so. And I got 24 tier 1s. Okay, shift sells 10, yeah, okay. 27 million. Now, bring on that pretty little Atlas. The DC. The DC is a command mech with wasted battle fist and a Leopard C3 link that I don't need, so I'll be taking that out. I do still have one XL engine, so it's going to go into it. Why am I standing here talking about it while it's still in the store? Put that in my mech bay. Got a full mech bay, so something's got to go. It's going to be something I'm not likely to use, and that would be this guy. No, I'm actually less likely to use the Archer, tell you the truth. But I'm not going to strip it. Yeah, I am. That's the Warhammer. What the heck am I thinking about? Boy. The Archer is stripped. I'll be darned. Put him aside. Save him, keep him. Okay, we'll do this guy now. Says Battle Fist, but he doesn't have any. That's gone. I think we already knew that, didn't we? Might have to do this in two stages, because that's not staying. That's not staying. That'd be good a long time before I'm gonna need it. It's gonna have an SRM, so I might as well leave that. Okay. Double heat sink. You're out of there. What do we got? You gotta give me bigger numbers than that. Boy, pretty sure I had a bigger one to start with. Oh, guys say that, right? I got a 3. Didn't I just buy one for 350? Erg. Okay, I can't just keep running all over the place. Buying stuff, so yeah, I'm stuck with it. Gonna have to do. unfortunately, I put all my good stuff on all the other mechs. This mech might well be a meat shield instead of a, good one. What do you think? At least I still had one of them left. Let's go ahead and do the ammo now. I gotta say that it's, Atlas's Go, this is not one of my favorite ones. I might stick with the Night Stalker anyway, tell you the truth. No mobility stuff. That's why. That is, this is not my favorite. This is, that's the max I can put in it without going with an LRM-20 instead of the twin streaks. And I'm not going to put a 20 in anyway. I'd put a 15 if anything. They are more efficient, we'll say. Got 11 tons. We'll try that and give him some ammo for it. And fill it up with joy in the size of large ice cubes. And this just became not my mech. Totally full, no spaces left. No, it's not true. I've got three right here. How's the heat? 3.2 to 5.1? Yeah, we can just do this. Let's be fair and pad that guy too. Well, it's an Atlas. The whole purpose and point behind being a DC is to have electronics, and it doesn't have diddly for electronics, so we'll give him an ECM. And I'll cut a half ton somewhere. Maybe. Nah. Where'd that ECM go? Well, done. 4 million, half my money. 4.7 million. Slightly under half total. 99 days. So the question remains, do I then go ahead and do a fight before I get there to give everybody a little bit of affinity in their mechs, or how should I run that? I know what you guys are saying. Fight the mech, Chuck. Fight the mech. What we got? A level 13 pirate hunt. 3 assassinations. Not 1. 3. That puts me back up on the money, doesn't it? I got 1,000,007 doing 62 days, and I'm gonna make 62 days to, how about that, nowhere, about Hartsville, because I believe that's a industrial hub. And that's 90 days. I'm gonna come crawling into this, 6,000 down. That's not a good idea. In fact, I don't have enough range to get there. And there's not another single mission in. I'm too far away. That's got to be the deal. There's got to be at least a mission in here. But what mechs can I use for it? Wait a minute. How far is this? 27 days. What's available in about 27 days? Everything but the Atlas. That's 99, so that's way out. Okay, you know what we're gonna do. I gotta make money, folks. I don't feel like selling off another mech. First mission or two of the extra inner spear missions are not quite 400 ton. So I gotta come down a little bit. I can't be selling them all. I don't think I'm gonna need any heavy mechs. Got contracts here. Okay, I got one 93 battlefield 400 tonner. They're all going to be 400 tons. I don't like tourmaline. I don't like sandstorms. What else is available? The single mission anyway. 94. I gotta go up anyway, so 94s. 95s. Okay, let's get over. It's going to be a 90, and there's not much difference. Oh, there's 80. I'm going backwards in time, though. I mean, I got to go up anyway, but I don't have to go back. Don't want to go back too far. Okay. We're going to go here and do the demolition in the next episode of Opa Plays MechWarrior 5. You kind of saw that one coming, didn't you? Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe, and we'll see you on the next mission there, MechWarriors. Till then, Opa's out.